I am about to make a very, 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 very crazy decision. It's your girl QR Cheyenne. I'm back with another video, and today I'm gonna be sharing with y'all some personal life update things. I made a very huge step, and I just want to explain to y'all my thought process throughout this moment in my life, what I plan to do, and really it's just a documentation so that y'all will see every part of that like journey. Y'all will see every level of like what happened behind that decision. So we're gonna get into that. Honestly, the way I started out that clip, I thought I was gonna put it at the end of a vlog, so just disregard how it's like worded and everything. Just keep watching. If you're new here, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, like, comment, and all my social medias be down below in the description box. Let's get into it. Before y'all clown me, I look ridiculous because like my headphones are like kind of covering my bonnet, but your girl is working. It's Sunday, September 15th, so I'm gonna go ahead and update y'all on what's going on in the life of Kiara. I am about to make a very, 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 very crazy decision, and I hope y'all are gonna support me and show love to me throughout this process, because I'm definitely gonna need it. My platform is obviously not the biggest, or I'm not the most popular person, and that is completely okay. But I do believe that with my 800 subs, with every one of y'all that are clicking my videos consistently, y'all are consistently watching me, y'all are consistently growing with me. I really do appreciate y'all, and I do give my heart, all my love, and my care to you guys, and I'm definitely gonna show that and give that back to y'all real soon. I need y'all support, okay? Because this next level, this next step is gonna require people to actually support the things that I'm doing, y'all. If you know me, you've known me for the longest, you know that I'm a fashion design major. I'm obviously into clothing. That's my dream goal. That's what I want to do. That's what I've had my heart set on as a career for the past 5-6 years. That is what I decided to do with my life. It wasn't my first career choice growing up. It wasn't the first thing that I wanted to do. Shoot, I didn't want to accept the calling. I didn't. But I realized that I really had the skills that I had, like, and I needed to run with that, and that was gonna take care of me regardless, because y'all, sorry, I'm working, but give me like 1 second. But y'all, I'm gonna break this. I'm about to put my 2 weeks notice in a job that I've been doing since the end of high school. I've been here, it was about to hit onto my third year being here within October. So when October comes up, that was gonna be my going on to my third year here. And obviously this is a job I started working for back at home, and I really just started doing it here because it was convenient last year, stuff like that. I didn't have to worry about finding another job. I could still be at home right after class and be able to, you know. But it's come to a point now where, because I feel like the company is so short-staffed and there's a lot of other personal things going on that I just can no longer tolerate or deal with out of this situation, it's becoming very hard to maintain and keep this job. I've been trying to edit videos for y'all. I've been trying to do homework. I've been trying to pick back up on my clothing business. And I can't do all of that when I only have 3 or 4 extra hours a day outside of classes. So then I work every weekend, y'all. I work every weekend. My schedule's not able to be changed. I'm not able to move from being off of closing time. So I close 3 days out the week and I work weekends. I'm covering the back end on things that other people don't want to cover for or can't cover for. And it has really took a toll on me simply because of the fact that, like, y'all gonna have to bear with me, y'all. Don't click off. I'm trying to work and talk to y'all. This is what's been going on the past 2 years. And my job is not understanding that. Like, they're not going to, honestly. And I understand that a business is business and it's ran the way it's ran for a reason. And they can't just, like, change their whole plan just because of me. You know what I'm saying? So it's like I had to take accountability, responsibility as an adult and decide, okay, like, if the job is not giving me this leeway that I need and this is not working out and those are my non-negotiables with a job, then I need to, like, reevaluate. And after so long of trying to, like, y'all, I've been working weekends since I was in high school. I've constantly thrown away my weekends. I've missed out on so much because I'm always that person that, oh, I gotta work. Oh, I don't get off till this time. And everybody schedules things when I have to be at work. It's not that I work crazy hours. It's not that I work at a bad time of the day. I literally have a regular schedule. It sounds good, probably to some people, because there's people working night shifts and everything else. They work until 11, 12 at night or all night. But y'all, it's inconvenient because if I got an organization meeting, if it's something that I'm getting a phone call, y'all, 1 second. Thank you for calling customer service. This is Kiara. How may I help you? My bad, y'all. I also can't, you know, let y'all hear the whole call either, because sometimes they ask for personal information to be said. So anyways, give me like 1 second. Okay, I'm trying to multitask because later on I have things I need to take care of, and I kind of need to finish this video out for y'all while I'm working, so y'all have a video by tonight. So you see how your girl grinding. But basically, y'all, as a young adult, as somebody that's only 19 years old, yes, I'm only 19 years old, a sophomore in college. I am a sophomore in college, and the classes, I'm getting more and more into my major. Not only that, I have skills that other people didn't even walk in with. I've worked under a designer before, well, designers before. I've interned under people. I was sewing and doing competitions in high school. I was doing all of that. I've made newspaper. I have accomplished a lot that I never would have thought I would have been able to do in my position as a young girl from the hood. Yes, I am from the hood of Florence. So with that being said, my family has faced a lot of struggle, and they're still struggling now, even with me being away at college. And I ain't, you know what I'm saying, I'm not gonna get into that because that's my family personal business. Cool. But it's just like, y'all, like, I am busting my tail to make sure that I'm making right decisions because I can't afford to not make it. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, y'all, I'm doing everything I can to do what it is not only that I need to do, but that I love to do. This isn't just about, like, the money or the fame or anything like that for me. It really genuinely is because I like to do everything I like to do. I like to do YouTube videos. I've been doing them since a youngin. Some videos y'all never get to see because they got took down. They're embarrassing. But I definitely been doing this a long time. I'm just now getting to a point where people are actually noticing me. And that's what's crazy, because it's taken me years to get to this point when it's taken other people. My camera died on me, y'all. But give me 1 second, y'all. I am still working. So yeah, basically, y'all, I have literally been doing everything in my power to try to walk into what it is I actually want to do. It's all in my hands, you know what I'm saying? But because I still have bills to pay, because I still have things that I have to take care of on my own, and I don't have nobody else to fall back on when I need it, it's like, it's hard for me to make those type of decisions. When y'all see people on here saying, oh, I quit my job and did content full time, baby, I salute y'all, because I'm currently in that position now where it's like, okay, I'm literally fixing to step out and let my job go and go full force into my clothing, full force into my content, and I'm hoping and praying that everything goes the way that I envision and the way I feel is gonna go in my chest. Like, y'all, it's a risk that had got to be taken, because me doing this same cycle and trying to alter everything in my life behind this job to try to keep it, it's not working, y'all. And when a job like makes you do something like that, and the job is literally temporary anyway, like, it's time for me to just leave it. Like, I'm in a whole different city and area. I don't even plan to come back. So either way, I'm literally going to have to let the job go, whether it's now or a few months from now. So, like, it's not like it's not going to happen anyway, but I would prefer to do it right now while I have some leeway and some room to still kind of try to struggle and take care of my extra bills that I don't have put back, so that I can, you know, get something rolling in to be able to take care of the rest, so I don't have to continue to work these jobs, because they're not for me, y'all. I've been working since I was 14. I've been hustling, grinding since then. I swear on everything. Y'all want a story time on things that have happened in my life, please let me know. I'll tell y'all. But it is just so crazy. Like, it is so crazy. But anyways, besides all of that, because that can come in a different video, a different story, a different time, it all boils down to that. Being a college student, your weekends is all that you have to get extra things done. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, throughout the week, I'm working, going to class, all of that. Can't work certain hours because I'm going to class. Can't, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like right now, y'all, I'm doing classes. I'm working 3 days out of the week. I'm working the weekends 10 to 6, Saturdays and Sundays. So it's like, picture having to get up at 5:30 to 6 o'clock for 2 8 a.m.s throughout the week. Still having to get up early the other 2 days because of online class. Doing all of that, going to classes, traveling back from classes takes a big gap out of the day. And then on top of that, 3 days out of that time that I'm doing all of that, I'm working. So these shifts are short. I'm getting off at 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock on weekends, but 7 o'clock. But if I'm having to turn around and get up early, y'all, if y'all know, y'all know. But when you have early classes like that, you got to get into bed by like 10, 10:30 to get a good sleep to be able to even want to function the next morning. So it's been really hard for me to adjust my schedule with me still having to stay up late to finish stuff and still have to get up early to be able to be at my classes or do my classwork. So, like, honestly, everybody has their own struggles, their own routines, the things that they are able to deal with and tolerate. But honestly, I feel like my situation is different simply because, okay, people have jobs and they have class. Some people don't have jobs at all. Some people can really focus on just college. Y'all are so lucky. But this is the problem. People that do have jobs and they're able to still juggle class, their jobs, and their schoolwork, they don't do half of the other things that I do either. They just do that job and go to them classes. Y'all, I'm doing content for y'all. I'm trying to build a business plan. I'm sitting here trying to work this job. I'm trying to do all of these different things. Like, seriously. And I've always been that way. I've always wanted to do multiple things. I can't ever just stick with one thing. It's just not in me to do that. I definitely believe that growing up or as I get older, I would definitely plan to have multiple streams of income because that's the best way to do it. You might be a little wore out and tired because you're doing a lot, but I definitely feel like that's best because think about it. Like, having a regular job is only going to get you so far. They're only going to pay you so much. And yes, that job may have certain benefits up to a certain extent, but like they don't always help the way that they should. So, y'all, like I'm really just at a point where it's just like I can't do it. Like I can't keep trying to serve them. And they, even though they have accommodated me to be able to work from college, they've adjusted my schedule as much as they could so that I could still go to class, still have, you know, certain off days throughout the week and stuff like that. It's just like, it's still not worth it simply because they're taking my weekends from me. I'm not even able to request off for anything because they don't have any coverage for me. So I'm stuck working those shifts regardless if I paid for something, had something important to do. They do not care. Like, they probably care, but, like, they can't do anything about it because we're so short-handed that, like, they can't accommodate me in that way. So, I can't take off work. So, I'm stuck missing out on important dates and important things that I need to be doing. I don't have enough time to do homework as it is, really. And it takes me a lot of time because I procrastinate or it takes me a while for my brain to really just process it. I know this sounds so bad and your girl is not slow, but I just be taking my time on stuff. So like it takes like what it may take somebody 30 minutes to lock in and do. It takes my attention span like hours to like really sit there and get it done because I be wanting to do other things. And it's just like, I can't focus my attention and lock in on it. Like, it takes me a minute. But anyways, your girl has just been trying to get her life together. Like, I gotta get it together. Like, if that means that I gotta struggle for a few months, y'all, trying to make this content happen, trying to make my business happen, this is the step that I'm planning to take, and I'm hoping and praying that nobody may not understand why I'm doing it, and they may not even think it's the best decision. And I know some people personally to me think that, but I promise you, when you locked into that man upstairs, y'all, when you locked into the most powerful, the most high, baby, I know that man got me. He always has, and I wouldn't have what I have right now. I wouldn't be in this situation or this environment, period, if it wasn't for God ordering my steps. So best believe that if all else fails, if it's not what I think is going to be now, God has something planned for me regardless. There's an opportunity somewhere waiting for me, whether it's what I thought or what it or something better for me in that moment. I trust the process. So this is me letting y'all know what I'm about to lock in and do. So I need all of the support. I need all of the views. Share my stuff. You know what I'm saying? Share me with your friends, people. When I start putting out my clothing, support that, y'all. Go shop, all of that. I'm still going to be trying to set up a way for me to ship stuff out. But as of right now, it's going to only just be for my college area starting out because I got to order everything else around starting. So it will be coming. A site will be coming and I'll be getting all of that under control. But yes, that is what I'm doing. That's where I'm at. And hopefully I've already made the decision before this video posts because this is a very personal thing. And I'm letting y'all in on something that I low-key probably should have mentioned later. So, I've always been a very transparent person. I've always been a very open person on my platforms. And this is one of those moments. So I'm not really necessarily embarrassed, ashamed, or anything of that sort, because I want y'all to see my journey. It says The Journey on my channel. Y'all, this is what I created it for. For y'all to come along with me as I'm walking into the steps to my career, as I'm walking into what it is that God has for me, all of those things. And that requires for me to be very transparent. Y'all are going to see what God is doing in my life. Y'all are going to see the ups and the downs. Y'all are going to see all of that. And I allow y'all to see some of that simply because I know it's encouraging, building up, and helping somebody on the other side of this camera or this device or this phone, whatever you watching on. So it's like, I don't want to be ashamed about it because I know that God put me in this position to be that example. So I hope and pray that y'all are getting something out of this. And I hope that this journey does help somebody. And I appreciate everybody that is supporting me, watching me, and cheering me on. Even though I don't see, even though y'all don't really reach out and say much, I do have a few people that do reach out and they will let me know, hey, like, you know, and I appreciate y'all for that. Because when y'all DM me and y'all let me know that what I'm doing is working in the way it's supposed to, that brings so much joy to my heart. Because I know for a fact God put me in that position to influence in the way that I'm influencing for a reason. So I thank y'all and I appreciate y'all. And I just wanted to share that with my supporters. I really need to find a name for y'all. So drop down below what y'all think y'all's names should be. But yeah, so road to 1K, trying to get my business up. Let's see what happens. Peace.